Welcome back, everybody, here to your G League Season 2 coverage. I am your host, Obi-Wan Kenobi, joined by Z Muffin Man for our final deciding game of Group A. The winner of this game will advance through into either the quarterfinals or semifinals, depending on the result, and the loser is out. There is no second chances with this. It all comes down to a best of three matchup between the two teams, which everyone thought was going to go through. They're the two of the biggest gaming houses in China, LGDCN, as well as DK. They're the two teams. One must have their head on the chopping block. We're going to find out over the next couple of minutes. Of course, the man who's been with me through a lot of these games already, as I said, my co-commentator, Z Muffin Man. Dude, what are you expecting from this matchup?
Hey, I'm just expecting exciting Dota. What a cracker of a match for the final group, for the final game of Group 1.
Yeah, it was something which we knew was coming. The schedule was quite obvious. Got it up on the screen right now. The schedule was very obvious that DK versus LGD was going to be the final one. And we kind of all thought that, yeah, it's going to be a matchup to see who gets first position in the group. But not a match for their lives. That was something which I don't think anybody was expecting.
Yeah, it's do or die. It's just crazy to me because I was excited to see these teams in the final end of the tournament not go out so early. And predictions-wise, all I can predict is it's going to be an awesome match.
Man,
awesome series. I'm
with you. Like, we were talking about this beforehand. For people on the VOD, if you do want to check out, like, the conversation we had before these matches, you can just jump yourself onto the live stream over on Join Dota. It helps make your VODs a little shorter, even though you think they're pretty long as it is. But one thing we were talking about before is, with this matchup, who really has the advantage? LGDCN, we kind of said that they are the favorites going into this matchup, but you got to say, if DK execute their aggressive strats correctly, then we could be seeing these guys completely walk over LGD. If it executes correctly. Yeah. It's a big if. It's a big, big if.
I'm still not quite sure with DK because they showed inconsistency in their games against 4Love, and then they showed that they can play good against LGD International. But I feel also that LGD International were making a little too many mistakes, whereas LGD China won't. They are a team that are less likely to make mistakes. So I do give LGD China slight favorites here, but it could go either way.
Yeah, that it could. Of course, like, if you're looking at the guys who make mistakes, then like I think God as well as ROTK get to take a large portion of the wooden spoon from these events. But LGDCN, they just, through their entire roster, they just look and play so stably. Like Zhao 8, he's been absolutely amazing in that middle lane. DDC, I know we wanted to give him man of the match in some previous games where I was like, you know what, he wasn't listed as it, and that was in their game they actually lost. But he's just been absolutely perfect on that support kind of role. So LGD, you know they're awesome, but I'm still wondering if DK can test them enough. And that was the weakness that we've seen from LGD. Like, we have it listed on our card right now. Like, they have a problem adapting to change. But it's not just change. It's when you add enough pressure and their lineup is not built for it, there's never like that plan B, it seems, for them. There's never this, if the plan fails, then we just leave it. They go, you know what, the plan's going to work because we're LGDCN.
Another thing I'd like to add is, oh, hang on, we've got something here. That's SC, DD.
Yep.
Coddle. I'm not sure if I've seen him play Coddle. But that could be a key hero in this series.
Well, we've kind of seen
Coddle. The ability to stop pushes.
Like, Coddle has come in and come out all the time. It always depends if you're up against Lone Druid. Because you pick up the Coddle and does no damage to the bear whatsoever. And this has kind of like been that feeling I've had through so many games. And speaking of a man who loves his bear, Lone Druid's up on his, as well as Lunar and Void. Probably one of the best, if not the best, farmer in Chinese Dota right now. Even beyond Burning.
I'd actually say his performances have been more stable than Burning. And yeah, you say he loves his bear, Burning also loves his bear. It'll be a fight to get that hero. I feel that it's going to be heavily contested in the draft in all these matches, really. Yeah.
Now we see DDC up on the board. Chen, Enchantress, NA. Like, if we look over the last couple of games with LGD International, Chen and Enchantress even being banned in both in the first two at one stage, just to stop it up against from Israel.
I find it quite weird, though, that it's listed there, because it's only LGD International that are running the junglers and not LGD China, so they haven't really been running those junglers.
It's just the key here of the player, I think, as opposed to like what's been the trend of this competition.
Yeah, I haven't really seen LGD China play the junglers for a long time, though. Maybe like a long, long time ago, those were his signature heroes, so that's why it's listed there. Mm. I know they like to pay tribute to a player's key heroes in the past, like Misery. He had his Potem listed there, even though he's now support. So there's like lots of respect given to players who've played great in a certain hero in the past.
And now we get to go through the DK lineup after going through LGDCN. So we get to start off ROTK.
The man ROTK.
I would love to see his first hero, which is listed there, the Tinker, come out, but Batrider and Windrunner are still happy to see both those guys. But yeah, we haven't even seen Tinker at all, come to think of it.
I don't think so, yeah.
No, not a single game has had Tinker.
There's just too much priority on other heroes at the moment. And for all the flack that we gave ROTK for the first game on his Furion, he really picked it up in those game 2 and game 3 on the Rubick and the Enigma.
We move on from burning. And, got to do your hair before you play. That's what it's all about. MMY coming in. Another man. We've got another Tinker on the field. as well as a Rubick and Lushrak. It's more than likely what we're going to see out from MMY this game.
Yes, indeed.
And then, the most awesomest guy in China. 357.
Why is he the most awesome?
Because he just is, man. And because he's wearing
the hat.
He's wearing his real cap. He's wearing his real cap. Not that picture one we have on our card. Because it's just not right, man. That's his real cap. Yeah. He went through one of the SMMs not wearing it, though. And that really weirded me out. He just wasn't the same then. It was like it's when God's cut his hair and Tammy Tang cut her hair. Just like, it's like, it's just not the same anymore, man.
Yeah, when you learn to recognize these people, you just pick out one thing, and it was the hat for 357.
Yeah, always the hat. Always the hat. Not to mention his gameplay, but also the hat. I would actually like make an item in the Dota 2 store that was 357's hat. Obviously, by the way, 357 is also QQQ, and will be referred to as such during the broadcast. It's because that's his new name he's been playing under. But the Chinese still call him 357.
It's his Dota 2 name. Mm. He changed it back when he was playing with Ehome for Dota 2. Oh, this awesome thing again. I love it.
Oh, wait. I'll show it on the live stream. The carries, the positions, the solos, the supports. And we'll see if it's accurate this time around.
Once again, they like to confuse our viewers, though. XB is ROTK and URU is Super.
Yeah.
They even have, like, they try and match them up. Like, carry Sylar versus carry Burning, support DD versus support 357.
Mm. Yeah.
And the Zhao 8 versus Super. I'd love to see a Zhao 8 versus Super lane in mid. That'd be a treat.
It would be kind of cool. It would be kind of cool. All right, so we do jump ourselves off that one, and the game should be starting off in just a couple of moments' time. A reminder, if you've just tuned in as well, guys, this is the deciding matchup between DK and LGDCN. Of course, LGD International earlier today were able to take the win 2-1, and that does put them now in a position that if they have first position unless LGD are capable of going 2-0 in this matchup. If LGDCN go 2-0 in this matchup, then they are the guys to take first position. DK is eliminated, and then we have the last two. So LGD International as well as I keep doing it, man. Seriously, I must be so damn tired. For love. I keep on thinking Tong Fu, and it's just no. Their next group, they come up tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but For Love, they will go into that third position. But For Love are also safe. For Love and LGD International, both teams are safe.
Completely safe. And For Love, I think they really needed that, at least that one win. Otherwise, their lives would have been on the line, maybe?
Yeah, if they got too zipped, then there was the possibility they could get knocked out.
Yeah.
But it had to go 2-0.
That LGD International got knocked out if they lost 2-0 as well. But that isn't the case. So both of them are safe. And DK LGD fighting for their lives.
All right, so Super's good to go. So is well, Sosa's asking, but both teams have said they're ready to rock and rumble. So let's get into it. The load gets to happen, which means it's game time, peoples. It's game time. And our last G League match for Group A. I hope you've been enjoying the coverage. I know I've been enjoying actually doing it. It's great to be doing so much Southeast Asia / CN, because they're not the same, Dota. It's been absolutely fantastic. And then we get to go the defense tonight because we've got three games for that one. But of course, big shout as well to everyone tuning in Dota TV and selecting this English live stream. It is great having you with us. Myself, Toby One as well, it's a Muffin Man. We will be here a lot more. It's great. It's fun. It's fantastic. It's awesome, Dota. So let's get ourselves into it, man. Let's get ourselves... Okay.
Let's start with priorities. Priorities between these two teams. I'm thinking Lone Druid. How about you?
I'm thinking Lone Druid. I'm thinking Batrider. But ROTK bans a hero, which, like, most Europeans would not be surprised at that if you went back, like, maybe 2-3 weeks. But ever since the change up to Skewer, like, we have seen Yao played in the offlane, and maybe that's the reason why we're seeing ROTK banned out right now.
Yeah, but, exactly right.
But even then, like, that was always a 1v1 offlane whenever they would pick up the Magnetor, and it would be a very, very late pickup, that grab as well. I think well, both teams just... are trying to bait the Lone Druid through. I think that's exactly what this is.
Really?
Yeah, I think ROTK wants it as the first pickup.
Could do. I mean, I think Magnus hasn't been as such a high priority as it is in Europe within these games in G League, but it's just because they're versing Yao, and Yao's probably the best Magnetor in China or in the Asian scene right now. So it's like a half respect ban, but half a proper ban as well. So it's both in one.
So Yao, wait. Who will their final ban be? And I think he's wondering the same thing as me, which would be crazy because my mindset is nowhere near as good as his.
Well, they're probably discussing Nyx.
Yeah. Oh, would you really ban... Oh, yeah, you would ban NA out because if that is first pick for ROTK...
It's just what it delivers in the team fights is nearly unmatched because he can just go in, use his spiky carapace, and then get out. Otherwise, the team gets stunned, and all five of them get stunned if they want to try and finish him off. They have to actually wait for the spiky carapace to end. So there we go. Armor bug taken out.
And
Lone Druid. There we go.
Yeah, ROTK is trying to pull it through. And just some interesting information, actually, about the Lone Druid. As far as win-loss percentages go, overall, it actually has a 33% win rate. So it's got 3 wins and 6 losses, so 9 games in total for G League. Burning has actually gone 1-1 on the Lone Druid, so 50% for him. And Sylar, would you believe in the 2 games he got that Lone Druid, both were losses?
Yeah, but you can't really pin it down to just the one here. It has to involve... The discussion needs to be about the entire game.
Yeah.
And I don't think we're ready to discuss every single game that Lone Druid has played
I'm just throwing out some fun stats for people out there that like to count all their numbers together.
Fair enough.
you had the same reaction last time I did this. It's like, it's just fun numbers at this stage of the game because we all know you've got to have synergy in a lineup. You've got to have focus through all 5 heroes. So there's LGD now. Right. Man, you must really hate stats. Like, Dota buff must be like your worst enemy ever.
I actually go to Dota Academy quite often. I love it. It actually tells a lot. But yeah, I don't rely on stats when it's on just such a few games. You need a bigger sample size because otherwise the stats aren't reliable. Keeper of the Light, I also mentioned being a possible key hero this game for its ability to stop pushes. Because at the moment, a lot of these teams like to get together early and take towers. And Keeper of the Light really prevents that from happening.
Yeah. It's also a huge amount of burst damage when it comes to the team fight. Like, we saw it earlier today with Rubick stealing Coddle's Blast and then also combining it with Fade Bolt. And it did so much, like, damage across the entire team when it happened. And like, you have heroes like Lone Druid as well as his bear that want to come in close, and that bear's now going to be removed out by Brewmaster's ultimate, sent it up in the air every single time, and that's a long time for the bear to actually have no effect whatsoever. And then LGD are able to walk over it. The question is still, are they going to throw the Brewmaster in mid, which means RTK. Does he try and come back with what has been kind of, I think, the main counter to Brewmaster, which is the Night Stalker? Nope, we're going to get the Beastmaster as well as the Chen coming the way of DK.
Wow, I don't think I've seen DK play Chen for a while. I'm pretty keen to see how they play it and how well they do with it. A bit more about Keeper of the Light. Whilst you'd say it does great damage and has that blinding light for the team fights, there is one drawback on him. His ability to gank early game and roam with smokes is pretty much non-existent. Mm. He's mainly just a stick in the lane with your other hero and control that lane and prevent pushes later. So he can't really go around and gank very well, unless he's got like paired up with a really good stunner like Sven, perhaps. Sven can line up that stun and then Keeper of the Light can illuminate over the top.
Yeah, and yeah, then you have that extra burst damage and maybe that's all you really need to do it.
But it's still hard.
Yeah, it's difficult. It's difficult. It's not like the lines we've seen it from LGD International, where every time they go somewhere, it's a setup kind of thing into another stun,
exactly.
Or it's a double stun, or it's some form of control from both heroes. And Coddle's got nothing in the very, very start. Like, absolutely nothing.
I find it's always about the Shadow Demon or the Rubik, because both those heroes have a spell that can set up perfectly for anything. You've got the Disruption from Shadow Demon, obviously, and the Telekinesis from Rubik. And the one time we did see something that didn't have a good setup, where there was a Leshrac paired with a Chen, they struggled at times to get the kills early on because it's hard to get in unless you've got something to set up.
Well, I'm seeing Darkseer SD banned out. I'm waiting for Rube because the final ban out from Xiao 8. Because I think there's no way in all high hell he wants to give that over to ROTK. Because then you got Chen and Rubik together, and that's the possibility for a Brewmaster Steel, a Coddle Blast, a Zven Stormbolt. All these options are there. It'll be a Rubik field day, basically. But the Animage and the Necrolite ban as well. Actually, was it LGD that played that earlier? Or was it...
Played the what?
Or was it Pycat? Pycat played the Necrolite earlier in G League. That's the only time coming to mind.
I think a lot of... Yeah, but a lot of Chinese teams have been seen trying out the Necrolite in official matches, and I bet they've been playing them in scrims too. So, yes, I've seen LGD try it, I've seen DK try it, but never with too much success, I have to say. But it's still obviously something they're scared about.
There's that final looter ban. Oh, man, can you also just check your microphone as well to see if you got your speakers cranked up, because there's echoing inside the game. I'm perfectly fine here on the live stream.
But tell you what.
Some people say
is it echoing from your voice through mine?
Yes.
I'll just turn you down.
Okay.
You're gonna sound like a mouse to me, but that's fine. Everyone else can hear the normal Toby.
We'll go with that. We'll go with that. I'm pretty sure, man, you're gonna hear me anyway. Me sounding like a mouse is never gonna work.
Right. A very strong mouse.
A very strong mouse. It's a mouse that right now with my voice as tired as it is and the lack of sleep I had last night, I get to actually drop down a couple of octaves so I sound a little bit more... I'm not full Barry White. I'm maybe Barry White's removed cousin right now. Oh, man, I can't believe we forgot about this guy that he got through so far. Undying was the last man out from Xiao Wei. How was he forgotten? Like, you picked up Sven over Undying?
It's just different priorities now between these two teams. It's still a great hero, but they just value these other heroes over it right now. They've got these plans with Chen and Beastmaster and Sven and Brewmaster.
ROTK. Not again. Not again.
We get to see that ROTK profit.
This time, he's going to be hoping a crap ton better than the last time we saw his profit. Which was very, very depressing for everybody involved.
Well, it wasn't so much his being picked off that led to the middle Rex going down. It was Burning actually deciding to take that fight when he should have just backed off and let ROTK die. Sometimes you just need to let your teammate fall.
Yeah. Just know what is collateral damage. ROTK should know that. Like, he's got his portrait is Bill from Left 4 Dead. And you got to know when to leave him for dead. And move on and complete the level. And then go on to No Mercy Hospital. Avoid the boomer, avoid the smoker. And if there's a hunter, make sure you've always got a possibility for a bash. Secrets of the game, man. Secrets of the game.
Yeah, but in Left 4 Dead, you always got to back up your mates, Toby.
That's true to a point, but if you have a chance to live, man, you make that run. You make that run. You complete that level. Sometimes you've got to cut your losses. Unless it's Zoe. If it's Zoe, then everyone has to turn back and save her because you never leave a woman behind.
I'm sure someone will turn that around and call it sexism, Toby.
That's not sexism, man.
Yeah, but the way people turn your things around.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Really, it was more of an offensive thing at every single red-headed nerd. That's what, like, everything I just said then was all insulting every single nerdy redhead guy. Yep, turn that one around. Let's move on. Hi out there to everyone professionally on Dota TV, as well as the Join Dota live stream. Lashrak pick up now for Zhao 8. So is this now going to be Zven core or Lashrak core?
I really don't know, because they've run Sven as core on Burning, but it hasn't been run very well. They didn't do the greatest with it.
And is Sven something Sylar has really played around with? Or are we actually looking at a Coddle offlane?
Sven was picked by Burning, sorry.
No, LGD.
LGD, I don't really know if Sylar's played much Sven.
I kind of feel this as a throw a left field thing out there. But either it's going to be an aggressive tri-lane with Coddle on the safe lane farming up. Don't ask me why I'm thinking this, because really, you can't understand my logic. But Brewmaster, nobody can, not even me. Nope, Void. Void pickup. And Zhao 8 Zven.
That's pretty cool.
So we get a mid lane Zven. So we get the melee versus melee again.
It can be mid lane Brewmaster still. Remember, these teams, it's mostly Zhao 8 in the mid solo nowadays.
Yeah.
They're still willing to.
It'll be Beastmaster versus Ven in the middle lane, which puts Zhao onto the off lane. Okay. Yeah.
I'm still not convinced. I think it could be Zhao in middle.
It could be, but then you've got to run Zhao 8 with Lashrak and Coddle supporting down the bottom lane, leave Sylar by himself. Because that's the weakness of LGD right now, is their offlane. Unless it's Brewmaster offlane, we go Wagamama style. Yao is playing as Brewmaster, so yeah, we can run him as the offlaner. But he's heading mid. He is heading mid. Sylar's heading top. Where are our last three headed? They're making a line for the bottom. So it is going to be DDC, Lashrak, Zhao 8 on this van, and SC as the Coddle, heading down towards the bottom lane. So you get Yao going up against, well, we don't know for the middle lane just yet. Supers there as the Beastmaster. Yeah, it's going to be him. He's built for bottle. QQQ is the Chen. Burning onto the lone druid. He's going to be safe lane farming, which is very much expected. MMY supporting as the Rubick. And that leads our final one, which is ROTK. He'll be taking the Nature's Prophet. And just judging by his build already, I got a funny feeling he'll start up on the top lane. That bear's going to have a long walk up there to actually pull in some experience. If that doesn't work, he'll move instantly into DK's jungle.
Well, the bear won't have to pull experience since it's just a solo Void top. I had a feeling they were going to do this. They like Sylar's chances up against the solo Furion. They've pulled him some regions. He's got Poor Man's Shield. Furion's harass isn't going to be too much for Sylar now because he's got Poor Man's Shield blocking 20 damage every time, 100% of the time of a hero's attack on him.
30 seconds to battle. And waiting for one person to reveal themselves. There's the bear showing itself first, and QQQ just in vision. Just in vision there for LGD. Even a tree going to search out. Yeah, they're checking in for Roshan. That's the main area they want to go. And now Burning shows himself on the bottom lane as well. So LGD know what they're up against. I'm interested to see just how well ROTK handles this. The competition this top rune. And Sylar, look how aggressive he wants to be. This is just exactly what ROTK loves to do when he runs around with the Magnetor. And then the Haste stolen by the bear. This is exactly what he loves to do. He loves to be so aggressive on this offlane, already bringing ROTK down to half life. He used the time walk to stay on his tail. But this is going to be ROTK, like either Munch or going to Tango. He's not going to pop the salve just yet, but he's trying to do some kind of revenge damage to Sylar.
This is really clever by LGD. Based on lanes, I already give LGD the favorites to win this, basically, because Sylar's going to do still quite well, even without the support. And now Burning is going to be under a lot of pressure because of that Coddle being such a great aggressive tri-laner, because he can spam Illuminate so much. And then you've got Zhao 8 and DDC who's setting up. There we go, there's a stun and other wave. Look at that. Look at that damage.
It's funny too, because the way they're approaching this, because Burning's been up against lanes like this before. He's been doing it with dual lanes exactly like this, because that's the position DK can somewhat like find themselves in, mainly over on the Dire side. So he has a bit of a different angle that he can use. But with this line from LGD, they can be so aggressive directly against Burning, and they're already rotating. They've smoked and they've gone, and they're heading up towards that middle lane to see if they can kill off Super, who is running really low. He just bought up his bottle, but this is going to be his death. There's the Storm Bolt to fly. Latrak follow-up, son. Should be perfectly in the mark. Do they have enough damage to finish this off? Yao is a little bit too far away. Right-clicking is there. Super trying to go inside the trees. The first blood is spilt, and Zhao 8 will be the one to take it. Getting kills in the middle lane, even though he is not running that mid-solo.
This is so beautiful by LGD. When most teams, they think, amateur teams at least, they think we must keep our core hero in the lane to farm and let the supports roam. They're just like, screw it, Sven, you've got the setups done for the Leshrac, so you go while the Coddle holds the lane. It's incredibly smart.
Mm. Just move, roam, and go nuts, man. And D-warding time as well. LGD. They're shutting down now the vision of DK, so they don't know where the rotation's going to come. MMY, nice pickup. Can you pick up? Yeah, he does. DDC up on the higher ground. It's 135 gold wasted. And also, they had to convert the courier to a flying courier just that little bit earlier. So now DDC, and the courier's out. He's stuck there for at least yeah, another minute and a half, because the courier's going to make the move and then back again.
Oh, a minute and a half is a bit of a stretch, but yeah, it's a long time
to wait. Courier travel time, because the speed's already been used.
Oh, true.
That's a long time, traveling up mid and then back again.
This is time for Burning to get a bit of CS. Look, he's
top lane, RTK. Going to go down, Zhao 8. He's rotated all the way from the bottom lane up towards the top to find that kill.
I'm watching this and I didn't even notice him move all the way at top. This is crazy.
So that's the reason why
meant to expect a Sven coming there.
Was that a misclick? I think it was. I think someone accidentally activated the glyph when they were using the courier, because the glyph just popped off for the Dire Towers.
Yeah, it would have been then.
Problematic for LGD, but not really at this point. Not unless Chen really tries to capitalize on it. And he is still farming up, like, he's got to hit that level 5 before he'll be ready to push. And have some kind of boots or control somewhere. But by the time he hits that, then Super should be 6.
Zhao 8, DDC looking for more.
Death, Rubick. Stunned up once, stunned up second time, and then 1 point in lightning will bounce around. Not enough damage to kill him off, that last right swing in from Sven. Finishes the job. And QQQ.
And that's got to suck for Chen, since he just cast Test of Fate to try and save him, and that's 200 mana that was wasted pretty much.
And he can't control another creep for a while now. Super gets a little bit lucky up on that top lane, even though he doesn't have the bottle. But he's able to just quickly swipe that Invis rune, while Yao continues to farm up in the middle lane.
Middle lane is quite even between Super's Beastmaster and Yao's Brew. I'd like to take a look at top.
Well, Sylar 21 for 8.
Quite fine.
And then, so is our OTK. Like, it's 18 for 4, even though he's got one death to his name. We all know like what Prophets can do with, like, if he does go Hand of Midas, or if more than likely we see him build up towards that. Well, does he go mech, or does Chen go the mech? I would assume Chen, but
I think Prophet might have to, since Chen, he has to spend so much time at bottom. He doesn't have
Sylar. He's going to pop the chrono to kill off ROTK. He should have enough damage to do this, or maybe not. There's a time lock. With that time lock, he can do the job, taking a lot of damage from the tower. But
ROTK.
That timing, man.
Bash, no kill for sure.
Yeah. He would have got back in range of the tier 1 tower. You saw how low life he was walking away, and he was walking away at that point.
And you know, he's had 3 levels in time lock and none in backtrack. Usually voids will get at least 1 level in backtrack just to help them tank some more harass. But he had 3 in time lock, so his chances were higher to get the
Well, looks like we've got a little bit of fun on the bottom rune right now as Yao finds himself up on a cliff. Chen on the run from Sven. Coddle Blast will fly over the top, and it is still going to be the death of Chen. But another hero who's called out of position. DDC, what the hell, man? He's walking in. He was split out. Okay, the stun was there to get Yao out, but he copped a lot of damage from all those ogres that came in from the side.
I gotta say, like, we see LGD International make really excellent use of Rubick and Chen, and DK just can't do the same.
Mid's dead.
It's like as if LGD Mid's China are one
Super
step ahead.
Stunned up, gets one last axe charge out. Maybe he could use his roar, but it's gonna be too late anyway. He actually does on Yao and then runs it towards the high ground. Quick bottle charge, and he is on the run. And he's got enough life to avoid another attack. 22 HP. He can TP out of this one. Maybe he can juke it around the corner. Will they try it? No, he goes up, he goes down, and Yao sees him. Right click death. I thought he was going to pop off that quick TP and get himself out to safety.
Like, while that kill's going down, Jout's already at top.
Yeah, coming in for ROTK. And that's going to be his death. That's why Sala was just so aggressive. Man, this is...
Zhao 8.
I'm wondering right now if LGDCN's been watching LGD International's replays and just like, yeah, come on, man. Like, let's do this. We know what we're supposed to be doing.
Well, I'm quite sure both teams are learning off each other, and they're learning as they go together. Zhao 8, he's nicknamed as Director 8 because of his ability to direct the game. And he's directing the game right now with this Sven. He's playing it as a roaming support when we thought it was going to be a core. So I'm really not sure who is going to have more fun, the Coddle. I think, yeah, Coddle's still buying wards and all that stuff, I think.
At this point, if you look through the gold per minute, the highest is Faceless Support at 381, then 315 for the Brewmaster, and then it's 255 for the Sven. So he's getting a lot more farm than Coddle. Coddle's at 158.
Yeah, he's...
And goodbye bottom lane. Position. Burning, yeah. Even in Ultimate form, it should be enough with that Lashrak stun, the Coddle Blast, and then the Lightning. Chen's killing up Brewmaster in the meantime. The Prophet TPing down. Maybe that was enough with a holdout. Burning, popping up the south very, very quickly. He needs to get through the trees. The Coddle Blast will finish the job. And now Lashrak, he threw out that stun trying to stop the retreating Burning. The Khan needs it now for ROTK. The Chakra gives him the mana for it, and he's thinking about it. He's got enough for a combination, and then the Sprout blocks the line super with the axe, clears the tree line, almost enough to kill off DDC. Then a 48 HP, and Zhao 8 in through the rear. One quick stun. Right click, not a secondary one though. Moves back to safety, but DDC limps back to base. What'd you give for a Sunstrike right now?
That's fantastic damage output coming from LGD. They managed to take out Lone Druid even in his tanky bear form with those three heroes like that. Like, a lot of the times at this stage in the game, once that Lone Druid hits the level 6, it's really difficult, yet they seem to manage quite easily. And I say easily, but it was still tough. Burning managed to run all the way down into some trees before he died. Just, I think the Keeper of the Light's burst damage from that Illuminate is a lot.
Well, you always said, set up stun and then go into the Luminant. He's got 3 points up in it. And he's even going to like annoy the crap out of ROTK now. Blast comes through and takes out two of his trees as well as his last hit. So he's forced back. Well, now Sila and Zhao 8, they team up together up on the top lane. Trying to bring down the tower while Rubick hangs in the middle lane the only way he can, which is with Invis. And he's now on level 5, so getting closer and closer towards that level 6. I'm about to say, then he can seal the Chronosphere, but Sila's going to love that even more because then he's got more room to move around. Because with the changes to Chronosphere, Sila no longer affected by the Rubick Chrono. He's able to walk around quite freely in both.
I have a question for you, Toby.
Yeah?
In the Western scene, what do the pandas go when they go middle lane? What item do they get first, Arcane or Blink?
In the Western scene, you look at Arcane.
Yeah. Yeah.
Every time, because
in Chinese scene, they're always going for the blink. They think the bottle and the magic wand is enough, and they need the blink as fast as possible. That's what Yao's going for here.
You can sometimes like offset, like even if you are running the bottle, like a lot of the time a Brewmaster will just want to have that higher mana pool, because that's one thing. Like you do notice, like you pop your clap, and then instantly you can't do another combination. Like, you're down to 200 mana points, and you require a grand total of 275 to actually make it happen. Oh, wow. Zhao 8. Not where he wants to be. Rubick picks him up and then takes him out. But he TPs out to safety.
Yeah, I agree with you that Arcane removes all the mana problems. But he can still get that Blink, Clap, and Ultimate combo off. It's just the Chinese, they value the blink and its initiate so highly that they rush it. There's just no time to waste buying arcanes. They need the blink now so they can take the initiation early for fights and towers.
That is probably the difference, though, like between like the Western and the Eastern scene, where you have the time to farm up the blink dagger after you've got the arcanes, and you actually use the arcanes to farm, because then you can just let the clamps fly. So it's a different way. It's just different timing.
Super. Like, he wants it.
He's going to get it soon.
It's going to be hard. It's going to be close.
Ulti. Pick up is there. And RTK comes in to help out with a Fade Bolt. But they lose a tier 1 town for it.
Well, I say close, but MMY, he just does the right thing and waiting, and then telekinesing once the roar is fully over. So getting the most out of their disables.
And now DK can add a little bit more pressure in towards that mid lane until Caudal Blast. At which point the pressure now completely dissipates. But look at DDC and Xiao Wei. They push out the top lane, they take out the tier 1 tower. Instant rotation. And they're looking into... They're going to find Super. They're coming in right now. No, they run the wrong way! You need to go this way!
Oh, so close.
Why can't they see my scribbles? They're waiting for someone to come and defend the top lane. That's all it is.
Someone reacts to Sylar at top.
It's going
to
be ROTK they're waiting for. They're waiting for his TP up here. Because Sylar's pushing and Sylar's got his chrono waiting. Xiao Wei, if only they knew how close they were. And then a tree scouts out there moving and ROTK moves back. But it is still going to be the tier 1 tower going down in mid unless there's more support. ROTK is here. He's just pulling the aggro off the tower for the moment. And maybe look for the denial. Yeah, they're forced back. They don't want to bring it in deny range just yet. They feel there's too much support. Or maybe they do. They're coming in. And there's
As good as LGD are playing this game, controlling the entire early game in the lanes, they did some good pressure on bottom, but then they left really quickly with the smoke, and they never came back. And Burning has been left alone for too long. 86 CS, and he's getting close to that relic.
It is kind of crazy. Like if you check out the Golden Experience, he's actually the man that's repaired the damage.
Exactly.
But this is what Burning does. This is exactly what Burning does.
The one beacon of hope for DK right now, Burning's farm, because they're losing in all other aspects.
Oh, we all know what lone druids can do. Chen even popping up the Hand of God just then. That was, of course, the Caudal Blast on bottom lane and for nothing else. Everyone was already sitting back a pretty good life. Watching Sylar on the top. Chance of him just jumping ROTK right now. Oh, he's not going to do it. He's not sure where Super and MMY are.
Yes.
So he just moves back a little bit. That movement is going to come down towards the bottom lane. Three heroes already looking to push, but at the same time, look at that rotation coming in from DK. Hearing Svenstone's out in the bear. So Xiao Wei goes down a little bit. I think he thought he was going to get instant chakra, but SC's already used it.
He'll get it soon enough.
Four heroes now for LGD on the bot. I'm going to feel pretty confident about this. Is there a ward off the side looking at this? Yeah, there's a dire ward. There's a dire observer ward giving him a good line of sight.
Chen managed to get the mech up. But he sacrificed his ability to move a little quicker because he has no boots.
Because then, what are we looking at for Midas? Well, Hand of Midas into what, though? Like, are we looking at him just trying to rush up a sheep stick or something? Is that an option?
Would be quite nice, or an orchid, just to stop heroes like Panda from getting their spells off the ultimate, or stopping from Sylar from getting away.
Maybe even
sheep
just
is very important.
Just to throw a rando concept out there, but maybe even just rushing up a Yule Scepter, because you're gonna have like.
It'd be quite strange. I'd much prefer him to get a hex.
Yeah, a hex is better because then you can actually kill off the Brewmaster. Like a Yule Scepter will just send someone up and towards the air, and that's not gonna help you much. Now bottom lane, you'll have to wait for a moment, man. We're about to initiate on bottom. It's Super in first. Roar goes out on DDC, not a single ability gonna pop off from him. And then Brewmaster, however, pops off his split. He's gonna bring down Chen to start with. However, Chen, he's actually able to get himself free. Gets the Meg charge off for his entire team. And now they can hunt the Brewlings. They want that Earth Panda kept close by, but actually they don't even care about him. They want the tier 1 tower. While the tier 2 tower on the top will be brought down by Xiao Wei as well as Void. There's God Strength being used for this one too. But it's going to be a tier 2 tower as well. Look at that blast coming. Nice resummon time by Burning. He didn't want to take any form of damage.
And they're finding
the backdoor regen for this. Something. They're fighting the backdoor regen to try and bring this down. Void takes the top tier 2. That creep wave is, yeah.
What the hell?
There's a range creep there, but I'm wondering if that's actually controlled by Chen. Nope, that's actually the creep wave. For some reason, it was a real creep wave there, but the backdoor regen wasn't stopping.
I don't understand that at all.
The TP now coming in towards the mid lane, Super and Yao saying hello. But it was like the glitch we saw yesterday where the Crow got killed off by Beastmaster Axes. It was a bug.
Is that confirmed to be a bug?
It was confirmed to be a bug. It's actually in developer forums that it's actually a bug.
Wow. That cost them.
Yao, pick him up. Oh, he's too late. Only just, though. Clap. Only just.
That death on the crew, that game cost him an incredible amount, you know?
Yeah. And that was LG the International.
So much so that it could have changed the entire game. When you're middle solo, like, when you lose the courier, all the opponent supports get that money. And that money early on is very important to get up key items like boots. And that can make the difference in the early team fights. I'm talking about, like, 5 minutes in.
Mm-hmm. It's also, like, even, like, the difference of, like, observer wards. Those things are so damn cheap right now. You get a small bonus and... Yeah. You get vision everywhere on the map. And now we see DK now going to push out the top lane. Yeah, they're looking for ROTK. And this isn't ROTK's fault. Like, this is him farming up. They're actually moving all the way down
he's
the
being
team
safe,
tower.
Though. He has his ward there, so
he'll know if they move.
It's like if there's smoke, then they'll get him. But even still, they decide to go for bottom. They're not going on a...
Yeah, this is tower trades now. There's already TP
they're
from
not going
one.
On a wild goose chase to look for ROTK in the jungle. They just want the tower at bottom. And both teams trade. Because like they can't really TP up in time to defend anything. Coddle here is doing the right thing. At top, delaying them. I wonder if LGD will just try and delay and push bottom.
I would say DK should just push in the top lane. There's no fortification left. And Radiant side, well actually they use theirs as well. Is this bear? Is there a resummon
for
it?
It's just too much. It's too much from the Coddle.
Maybe not.
Gonna be taking this bottom tower.
Maybe not. Just start up. Start up on the tower, man. They're already halfway through it. This bottom lane. Sila can't do it all by himself. And the problem he has is if his team gets in a little bit too far, then he's gonna TP himself in to help out. But yeah, it does look like DK's falling back.
Yeah, LGD's. It's just completely the keeper of the light to illuminate there. He takes a while to charge it up, but once he does, it's 500 damage nuke, and that clears entire creep waves pretty much. Mm. Even with the Chen's creeps and the Furion's creeps and the Scylla Bear's bear, Coddle is enough to hold them back.
And Burning. Do you notice too, like his Radiance came up at 15 minutes? Like after that start on that bottom lane, and he's still able to get 126 CS.
Yeah, they didn't push him that much. It was just the one bit of harass, and then they pretty much ditched the lane.
Mm.
And the saying goes, you can't leave Burning alone for too long. It's the trade-off. They did. They dominated middle and top LGD, but they traded off by letting Burning get quite a few creeps early on. And now it's a real battle this game, because LGD were dominating, and now it's sort of starting to even up. It's going to come down to whether or not Scylla can dish out the damage in those big team fights.
Well, middle lane, SC trying to get himself out. Actually, DDC helps him out by using the split out to clear off the trees. And then mech charge to ensure they're back. My apologies for not updating the overlay. It wasn't Drascal casting with me. It is in fact Z Muffet Man, so I have now updated the overlay. My bad. It was the same from before, from this morning. Everything else was changed. This middle lane now going to be forced out. Look at Zhaoed. He kind of wants to fight. He's got like double damage, baiting someone to come in. Start that Stormbolt animation too, an MMY.
Oh, wow. Rubik's got Stormbolt. Stormhammer. That's such a nice item to steal. A nice spell to steal, not item.
Oh, look at him, look at it. There goes three ways done. Roar is there in the best rating on Xiao Wei. And the Lestrak's done. Perfectly done on Yao as well. He'll get the split for Xiao Wei. He's already on the sideline. Big boy Chrono. Finish up QQQ. He's the one on lower life. And he does go down. So no instant heal coming out. And RTK burning up with the Brueling Spirits. Burning still on the run back out of here. He's going to get this bear back in. RTK getting stunned up. Then the Sven's done. Actually returned by MMY. Holding both Sailor as well as Yao in position. The Brulings are over. And Yao is so low on life. Then he seals clap and returns it. Everything they've got, they're using. Sailor's on the leap back out of here. Hesley's on the run with DDC as well. Bear to the front lines. The bear starts burning up and Sailor back behind the tier 2 tower. Axe to fly, Coddle blast. Careful about who gets caught in that one. Burning does still have a bear resummon, so they're going to force this tier 2 tower in the mid. In fact, he just resummons it straight away. Three right clicks, he's too far out of range. Have to recall the bear back in again. And then it starts burning up DDC. First stun, second stun, time lock. Axe to fly, trying to just like deter LGD from continuously hitting on that bear, which was only freshly resummoned.
The question was whether or not Sylar could dish out enough damage as Void, and I don't think he can, not just yet. Even with the Brewmaster playing that fight exceptionally well, he threw the Spirit Bear up into the air with his Cyclone from the split form, and Burning pretty much was doing nothing for a good portion of that fight, but they managed to just tank it out. LGD not being able to deal enough damage in time. And then once Pendant Split finished, DK took the reins in that fight. But yeah, they get the tower there, but it's not the biggest win. Game is still very close, Toby.
Yeah, that it is.
Like, if we check the XP in gold.
I'll check it in a moment. Sorry, I just realized I changed the overlay, but didn't change the sizing for it. So what are you looking at? Well, DK, it's only 1,500 and only 1,000 for the experience. That's not enough to write home about, especially when it's 5-10 up on the board. And if you look at the tower advantage too, it's a one tower advantage in favor of DK, and that is basically half of that gold anyway. The difference is all about the map control and positioning. And at this point, like, who's really got the map control? Dire got one ward watching the movement up, and then Raiden got even a deeper ward. Like, they're watching DDC farm right now. And then you look over towards LGD, and they've got one aggressive ward inside their enemy's jungle, and then they got one ward which just now times out watching the bottom rune and Roshan. But the fact that the Ursas were already moving in there is going to make LGD think that Roshan's already being done. Because that's what DK are assembling themselves. Where are these Ursas running?
I think that's BKB for Sylar.
Are these Ursas meant to be running up here? They've basically got... Yeah, they've gone walkabout. They're heading up. Yeah, look at the pings coming out from orange. He's like, yo, dude. Misclick, huh? Misclick.
You think?
They've gone AWOL. It's like playing like Rome Total War, and the enemy is scared and is fleeing.
Trying to find... I don't think a player of QQQ's level would be misclicking Ursas. They're scouting and trying to find LGD's position on the map, because Roche now is a very, very, very important objective at this stage of the game. Mm. You want to see where the enemy is on the map. Even if it's just one or two heroes, you want to know where those one or two heroes are.
Look at the setup there. Now the troll together. It's his own portable army. The trolls are moving up, the clap's here, and they find Xiao Wei to start with. First clap, is there a troll trap? There's a Lestrak stun, and already both the claps being used. And then the Sven stun follows through, so already picking up two super. Roar, however, Xiao Wei, maybe a little bit of overcommitment, but then Yao jumps himself in. MMY, he just stole Stallhammer again. Now, Brulink's popping off Sylar, holding that ulti off. He's already popped his own BKB, so he can finish off super, which he'll successfully do so. Chen gets sent up in towards the air as ROTK is on the run. And he'll hit the deck in a moment. Remember those level 3 Necro units? They're hitting the deck as well. There's a Stormhammer, but great Chrono. Two heroes caught out on the retreat back out to safety. The Sylar will take care of them. Maybe picked up and thrown back down again. Chrono was stolen. Hold Xiao Wei out of the action. MMY is trying to TP out in time, and he will do so. Saves himself, but can't save his teammate. The Burning is on the run.
Well, that was unexpected. You thought they just weren't ready to commit on that Sven. Maybe Super shouldn't have blown that roar on Xiao 8 Sven.
The upside now for DK is the fact that they did not lose the lone druid. Burning is still up now, able to farm up and push out all these lanes. And he's still their key hero. It's just the downside is the fact that Silent has got a large chunk of farm and puts that BKB to instant use. Maybe that's what DK also weren't really expecting, that BKB to come out of nowhere.
I'm not
Super.
Like...
Super. Roar on top lane. And Provost going to TP in to help out for this one. Remember, this is an Aghanim Scepter Roar. So it's huge range. Pick up, throw down. MMY steals Time Walk. Oh, Xyla. He started the TP. Now he's sprouted up and held in position. There's no way out of here. He's backtracking so much. But he still goes down.
Maybe he should have just tried his luck. And, you know, because if he TP'd and backtracked enough time, he may have lived.
Yeah, because there was no stun left.
That's that Aghanim Scepter you mentioned on Beastmaster contributing to that kill there. Like the extra range just wasn't expected from Scylla's Void.
I also have to correct myself from
before.
Can you
roar like out of vision? How long is this roar's range now? Cast range, 950. So at night time you can roar from out of the fog, but not during the day, I think.
Well, it depends on the hero.
Depends on hero. Different heroes have different visions at night. Mm-hmm. I think Nightstalker has really great vision at night. Same with, I think, Luna.
Yeah, but his vision during daytime is a lot lower. They're running this gem around now with the Beastmaster and the Aghanim Scepter, so LGD, they're going to lose control everywhere on the map. If there's a ward somewhere, Beastmaster's going to find it. Hawk just got up on the high ground and then the board to get rid of it. He never needs help to do that as well. And then just this rotation in towards middle lane. DK have removed every single outer tower now for LGD. Their problem, though, is still pushing into a base up against a Void Chrono and a Coddle Blast.
Exactly right. And the Brewmaster blinking and clapping and Primal splitting.
Yeah.
It's just going to be too much at this stage. It's going to be a slow grind, I feel. They're smoked, but LGD aren't a team to let you smoke and gank them. They're already staying in their base. Oh, they're smoking themselves.
Yeah, they know what's going on because Beastmaster popped off the Call of the Wild and then got rid of one of the wards, so he was there with the gem. So they know exactly where DK are moving. So they smoke up, they go around the back, and all they want to do is just catch one person moving in the wrong position, and they're not going to find anybody, actually, because already we've seen DK move themselves back. They're checking up on the high ground, realize Ancient's been niggled a little bit, but no one else is here, so shout out, we'll go to farming. It's a frustration bolt right there, man.
The gem pickup is extremely crucial by Super here. Vision is possibly the most important thing right now. Vision so you can secure a Rosh or secure a fight with an advance, starting with an advantage. And it all comes down to the positioning of your heroes before fights start.
Play the vision game, play the lane game. This bear's just doing it by himself right
Shall
now.
Wait, he's very far up. I don't know what he's thinking.
Oh, yeah. He's going to get roared up, and RNTK's here as well. Yeah, what is he doing out this far? He gets one stun off. But RNTK, it's just...
Director 8.
And he's done so well with rotation, and now that's...
I'm quite sure that was not in the script that he wrote.
Pun central.
No, literally, there was a video where he was talking about G1 League. How he's like, the script has already been written. We win, and they did win. True story.
Happened to a friend of mine. Now into Roshan. Time to bring down the big guy. At the same time, Brewmaster already been forced back by a copy of Lone Druid. So they've got Vision, they've got a Tornado that's going to make sure that no one can just sit on the high ground and just harass him down. While that top lane was being pushed into, SC as well as EDC went up there to try and stop that, and Yao, even he's getting entangled up in the middle lane.
They're taking a long time to kill it.
No, that's because they're not bringing the bear in. The damage dealer is not there.
Mm-hmm.
But the damage dealer is trying to stall off LGD, because while he's been appearing in the lanes, they're like, well, where the hell is he? Is Burning, who currently sells one, Branch,
and
then
right there would never have happened if Xiao didn't get picked off like that.
Do we start saying, like, Xiao 8 is the new...
Spot the ROTK bug?
Yeah. Yeah. Look Maybe. At the bear making you move up. Look for that ensnare. He's out of range. He's out of range. He can't attack. But he has that assault cuirass as well as the Radiant, so he doesn't care.
It's only once by Xiao 8, so we let him off for that. It's a real worry for LGD now at this stage. DK have control of the map and they're leading in the net worth for their three core heroes. It's only Sylar that's keeping up on the Void. It's going to be a real challenge for Void to fight this farmed DK squad.
Well,
Burning with the Aegis, this is just trouble.
He's going to
Can
try.
Coddle delay it?
They're going to try and bring down the bear. Small stuns, another hold as well. They're using a lot of abilities up on this bear, and Sylar's got a lot of damage already just by doing so. And at the same time, ROTK is pushing out the bottom lane.
Oh, did you see that? That's very clever.
What was I looking at?
Chen sent the spirit bear home so it can heal fast.
Yep.
Rather than walk all the way back to base, Chen sent it home. So then Burning can recall it back, pop like this, and then they can do a little bit more damage to the tower. They can grind the tower down like this. It's just chipping away at it.
The funny thing is, too, they can bring in supplies doing that, too. Just throw something up on the bear and you bring it straight back again. It's basically a instant courier. And they're going in. Like, Zhao 8, again, all these abilities being popped up, trying to bring down the bear. Now the Roar flies out, and Sylar acts to fly as well. Man, Zhao 8, he just got hit by the Test of Faith, MMY. He ends up stealing Stormbolt out this one, and he can throw it out in Sylar, but Sylar, he only chronos up on the bear, of all things. Yao jumps in, he's got no mana for his ultimate. Right now, he's being entangled up, he's being locked down. Yao's gonna go down without getting a single ulti off. And then, however, the Beastmaster will take a fall, but Zhao 8, so low on life, still burning down. Entangled, first force swipe, he gets it too. Rubick gets his life, picks up SC, throws him back down again, and LGD going 2-zip is looking less and less likely. Gems on the deck as well. DDT's back, buyback by Sven. The bear's almost gone. Fortification will save the tier 3 tower. Stun out NARTK. They turn around. They've got to save him. The resummon. Look for an entangle. Doesn't get on the first one on Sylar. Now over to Zhao Wade. Proper Dolan going to fly through them too. RTK still alive for the moment. Sven's done. Thrown out by MMY towards Sven and the entangle. That's Zhao Wade's death. Burning. Getting stunned up a little bit. He almost brought down Sylar just then. Now moving over to DDC. On the retreat back past the tier 3 tower on the top lane. First poor swipe doesn't get him. Second poor swipe doesn't get him. But he'll just burn from the rest of the bear. Lashrak, however, there's the one who gets to take the kill, and they will take mid-racks.
Wow, I gotta say, Panda not being able to get his split off, and that Chronosphere on just the Spirit Bear really cost LGD. I think it was ROTK's Necro Bolt burning the mana of Brewmaster, and he just wasn't expecting to not have enough mana to split. LGD really on the back foot here.
What you would give for
this,
like arcane boots for the mana pool and and instant regeneration? Just saying.
Well, the Vlad's is very useful too.
It gives you a slow regen, but it's the pool. It's the pool you want. It's like watching
about the regen of the Vlads. It's about the aura. It gives like armor, damage, the lifesteal. So in the middle of the fight, you're lifestealing back as well. It's like a lot of things combined in one. It's also really good for the Void, the lifesteal from the Vlads, because it helps the Void out a lot too. It's just the Burning Scylla Bear. It got the first pick this game. Will it be banned the next game? I think so.
100%. 100% it has to be banned.
You know LGD will want it for Sylar.
But it's not just that, though. Like, it's not just the Lone Druid Bear. The Bear is doing it because he got given space. But the Playmakers are still coming through Super, are still coming through MMY. It's coming off the back of that quick Aghanim Scepter for the Beastmaster. And then ROTK just keeps the lanes controlled, and then mana burns out the Brewmaster when the fight begins. And soon, actually, basically right now, he has enough cash to pick up a full Scythe device. He's TPing bot. Oh, no, cancels it, and then TP's in deeper. Sylar sent back, attack him!
Oh, if he got the right click off, he wouldn't have been sent back.
Yeah, but he needed to TP into this region here, but he didn't want to dive in too far. Because he got blocked. The vision of this tree here blocked him. He couldn't see.
Yeah. That was close. I gotta say, though, this is looking to be over for LGD now that ROTK's got the Hex on the Furion.
Yep, there it is. Full Scythe of Ice. And they're not gonna push
in.
This
will have to be the perfect fight for LGD.
The question is going to be, like, though, is LGD ready for this side of the Vice? They're going to know he's going to bring something in. There's a Storm Ball out. Yeah, they definitely know it now. And that Bear is copping a lot of damage. That follow-up stun, that Bear is going to go down. It tried to be pulled out there by Chen, but was not possible at the end of the day. So Burning Force to resummon.
And it's Chen... a minor setback, but not the biggest deal. I wonder if this is enough to make them back off, or that will they continue to go?
Well, Lara TK has already gone up towards the top lane, probably because I think in the next 20 seconds they're not going to push in. But you also notice, too, that Courier bringing down the start of the Butterfly for Sylar. And he's that quarterstaff. He's just over 100 gold short of it.
I think Super just finished his pipe, too, so that'll help a lot.
Yeah,
helping
did.
The heroes and the creep wave tank the Auto Blasts.
Notice the secondary Hex now coming out, too. Rubick starting to build towards it. And now
wow, that's a rich support.
ROTK, we've got a lot of rich supports on DK. TPing out just at the right time. This time it's a lot better as far as his control and the lanes go. DDC's even surging room with that four staff, but... yeah, that's just smart times for ROTK out. He keeps the pressure on and doesn't get himself caught out. That's what he was struggling with. So he's really struggling with his last Nature's Prophet game. And now he's getting it perfectly right. And it's able to happen too because Burning's giving him the space.
He did, like, cop it a bit at top, but that's just the trade LGD were making. They were shutting down ROTK's lane at top, and the Burning Sillabear was getting some creeps at bottom in the meantime. So you can never shut down all three lanes against DK, or against any pro team, really. The most you can ask for is to win two lanes.
DK's now going to force the bottom lane. Burning would love this tower. With the last hit in it, it'll also have his Monkey King bar, which instantly counters whatever, like, the Butterfly Void just brought up. And just beats it down. Lone Druid gets the last hit. And that's actually... well, actually, he's a little bit short. He's short by 10 gold. May lose the bear. Chen might have to pull it out right now just to save it. Void jumping in. Starts on Burning. The Roar is there. Buys some time. Four starves away by the Rubick. And now, whoop, Chen bumped into the corner. He wants out too. Blinding Light will force him back again. And Burning, he will go down. You're right. He lost the Aegis the Immortal. Can they kill him off, though? They're not close enough to finish him off. Yeah, Void, he's beating him down. He gets him too. He managed to get a proc during the middle of that ulti, giving him double damage. And there goes the Chen. Lone Druid, instant buyback. He's TPing down the tier 2 town. There's Mana Leak on ROTK. Forsyth is actually not helping him as much as they'd like to. He's trying to get himself away. Doesn't leak out completely. Pick up, throw down. Stops Cottle for a moment. Already Nature's Prophet on the sidelines. Super's already here. Lone Druid coming in from the side. This one bear, MMY, burns off. And now the Lone Druid bear is looking already to kill off SC just by the burn effect. He has to bring it back in again. Look for Entangle on Xiao 8. Can't find one. Sven Sun does the job. And now Burning, he turns into right-click form. He wants the range. And now Sylar says, thank you very much. You've got little less life. I can bring you down. But that bear, look at the damage it's doing to Sylar. It's forced away. And Sylar's on the retreat. This bear is chasing it down, and if just with the movement speed, it can kill off DDC. There's a stun. ROTK! What are you doing in there? That is crazy! And now Void's gonna jump down, chasing Super. He got the slow, and he gets a time lock. Sven's done. Super's dead. Oh! Whoa, 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 whoa.
A little too greedy there. I just want to say, wow, as soon as that bear Aegis went, LGD flipped the switch and they went for it. Like, you'd think, oh, people might think, oh, LGD, they're being pussies, they're being bitches. No, they're being smart. They were avoiding a fight until that Aegis went, and then they initiated, and Burning went down. He had to buy back, so that's going to set back his next item. And the next Rosh now is
30 seconds.
Up for grabs. Very
30
soon.
Seconds until Roshan arrives. If everything worked perfectly for LGD, that fight would have gone for another 30 seconds longer. They just rotated in, pick up the Aegis the Immortal with the cheese, and then just go complete nuts. Actually, is that second Roshan or third Roshan we're now facing up against?
Third Roshan that comes with the cheese. So the second one doesn't have the cheese, but...
but are we up to two or three?
This is up to number two.
Okay, it's number two. I think I'm a Roshan ahead of myself.
Yes, it can be quite confusing after casting so many games.
It does, man. It does. Oh, man, I cannot believe, like, maybe ROTK heard us before and was just like, yeah, okay, it's my turn to die. It's my turn to die. I gotta throw this game, man. I gotta throw this game.
It was just an overcommitment. Being greedy.
Yeah, TPing blindly into the mid. Actually, it wasn't even blindly. They had an observer wall. They knew exactly what they were getting into. Like, exactly what they're getting into. What hurts actually more is, oh my
and
god.
And Jao 8 and DDC, they found Horo TK.
Oh, I managed to hit my mute button just in time. Yeah, you're right, ROTK is dead. Again, another, now 70 seconds with him on the sideline, but at the same time, Yao, Raw, look at that range it has! Forced up in the middle of trees, he's blocked in there, but it was enough time to get the Brewmaster Alderman off, and now Burning, stunned up, he's forced down into the Rosh Pit, and away to safety. For now, Chen set up in towards the air. The bear is still doing his burn damage, and Chen now four staff down. Sylar will chase him and then just start beating him down. Neck charge, Hand of God is there too. He'll let it rip, and he wants back out again. Not going to happen. Spirit Bear, now it's the focus. Turns around a little bit. Maybe they want to go. Look at SC. It's a Chen creeps. Able to get a couple of stuns off, and then maybe that burn damage. They are still bringing down LGD bit by bit, little by little. Connor Blast will go, and the bear is still finally will be brought down. There is a resummon.
It was a very questionable BKB by Sylar, but I don't think it matters. I think they can take this Roche maybe without the Chen and the Fury in here.
We're going to try. The bear's coming back in again. He's looking for DDC
or
SC.
As Burning can poke, you know, Chrono's still up.
That's true.
This is LGD's Roche.
They're going to try it. Bear is in, starts up on Yao. Yao instantly entangled, jumps up, and now there you go. Chrono is up, a super, able to get the roar, slowing down Sylar's effectiveness during this one. They even kill off the Lashrak with the axe, but Burning locked in. Prophet coming in, he's able to get that hex off. So Burning forced up back down again. Yao's on such low life. This bear's been doing its work, and now it does finish its work. Burning with a double kill now, moving on to Xiao. Wait, these Necrogears chasing him down. Lashrak will buy back. What is happening with this bear? It's going to be him retreating out. DDC stun is going to stop ROTK, but Burning with a triple kill, he finds the void.
You didn't have the screen on Sylar's death, did you?
Sorry, no I did not.
He was TPing out, he almost got out, and then the last second, the Spirit Bear entangled, it was so close. And like, I actually thought DK couldn't contest that Roche, and it was so close. Burning, it could have died. They just made the decision. They didn't want to give up the Roche, and it paid off.
And now they're going to take the bottom rack. Sylar, four staffs ROTK away, so now he's picked up, thrown down. The Sheepstick is already doing his job. Burning trying to get back into Alderman form, but it's still going to be his death, and that's the Aegis Immortal now popping off. Svendorin takes the fall. Sylar will follow through, so it does look like DK can finish this job right now. They will take a second rack and get the GG out from Xiao 8. So LGD will not get the number one position. Okay, because they cannot take this out 2-0, but DK, they're also one win away from knocking LGD completely out of the G League.
That's insane. LGD, they were the champions of G1 League, the champions of the Asia. You wouldn't expect this, but they're fighting for their lives.
There they are. There they are. We're going to be back here in a couple of moments, guys. It is going to be DK. They've stopped moving, so it's going to be a while before we actually know. Looks like the Creep Wave is bringing down that mid, so we might stick around to the very end stat screen for all those people out there that love that. But man, like DK, there was still a couple of moments, like those, the amount of times we saw Nature's Prophet get completely caught out. You thought, you know what, this is just... It could have so easily been LGD's.
It's just LGD. When there's a will, there is a way. They didn't manage to find that way this time round, but they stuck in for so long.
I kind of almost want to put a little bit more points up right now for DK's four-star use. Between Chen, QQQ, and MMY, during that engagement around Roshan, using the high ground, using the low ground, forcing LGD to chase them around everywhere. You've got heroes like Void and Sven and Brewmaster that all want to get in so close to do their damage, but the second they did so much. I'm like, when they killed off, they're trying to kill off Burning, and he just four staffed to the other side. It's like, well, I got to chase him down. And then you jump down, then you hexed up. It's like, there's all these problems that were coming for LGD where they could not have the time to do the damage.
The only thing Sylar was doing that last fight was at Rosh was trying to kill Burning. He then time walked down that cliff to kill Burning, and he wasn't killing anything else that time, and that's what made the difference.
All right, guys, we're going to be back here in a couple of moments' time. Game number two of our final starting match, DK. Will they go through to Zip, or will it be LGDCN? You'll find out in a couple of moments' time.